Good morning, dear students. You're welcome back for the biology class. How are you all? I hope you all are good. So today, students, we are going to talk about our last lesson of biology, that is management of natural resources. Actually, this lesson is belonging from EVS, means environmental science, okay? And most of the questions, means value-based questions and tricky questions, twisted questions, are asked on this lesson, that is natural resources, our environment and management of natural resources. So this lesson reading is most important thing. Line by line reading of this lesson is important. Means this lesson seems to be very simple, but these lessons to give answer is little difficult, little tricky, and some vague questions are asked based on this lesson. So prepare well for this lesson. So we are going to start with the management of the natural resources. See, students, we have four kinds of Indian text, ancient Indian text, that is Samved, Yajurved, Rugved and Atharvaved. Okay, so among these four, Atharvaveda is also one Indian ancient text. Okay, in this ancient and Indian text, there is one part. There is one part into the Atharvaveda that is called as a Maha Upanishad. And in this Maha Upanishad, there is one phrase, Sanskrit phrase, where phrase is written, and that phrase is Vasudhaiva Kutumbakam. You have listened this phrase various times. What does it mean in Marathi or Hindi or in English? The meaning of the phrase Vasudhaiva Kutumbakam is that the entire earth is our family. Means we both are living factors and non-living factors. We are the integral part of our this family. Means entire earth is our family, and so that we are living in a harmony. In a family, we live in a harmony, right? In our own family, we live in a harmony. All family members are living in a harmony into the family. So this is the earth that we say as a family. So all non-living components and living components are living in a harmony. How can we prove that? See here, all traditions, our customs, our crafts, our rituals, everything is according to the nature. We manage them according to the nature. We can look at various rituals are there, various customs are there, our crafts, our festival, everything is depend on the nature. Means according to the nature, we try to manage them. Understood? So this resources, according to the resources, we try to manage everything of our lifestyle. So this is the topic on which we are going to talk, that is resource, management of the natural resource. So first of all, I would like to clear the concept of the resource. What is mean by resource? The thing which are supporting the life, or the thing which are useful, fruitful for us, that is called as a resource. So I am the resource for you now. This board is resource for you, for me now. This is resource for me now. This camera on which I am recording my video is resource for me now. So these are some resources. Now you are using your mobile phone, your laptop or your TV screen, that is resource for you now. So the things which are useful for us is said to be resources. And the things which are not at all useful for us is called as a waste. Okay. So here in this topic mainly we are going to have a focus on the natural resources. Means how to manage the natural resources. Okay, so there are mainly two kinds of natural resources on which we are depend. Okay, that is means here in this topic we are going to talk about two main natural resources, that is forest and water. Means wildlife, forest and water, we are going to have a talk more on it. Various kinds of natural resources are present around us, that is air, sunlight, soil, right? These all are natural resources for us because we are using them, okay? So, but here in this topic, we are going to have focus on the wildlife and the water. Okay, so resources and the man-made resources or the artificial resources, what? Which are made artificially. See, you are sitting on the benches, right, on the tables. These are the artificial resources. These are made from the natural resources, but these are the artificial resources. So resources are mainly of two kinds, that are natural resources and the artificial resources. Okay, there are two other main types of the resources are there, that are exhaustible resources and inexhaustible resources. Students, exhaustible resources are the resources which are in a limited quantity. Exhaustible means are not getting tired. Don't take the proper exhausted. I have exhausted today, we say, means I have tired. So tired resources, don't take the meaning tired resources. Resources means these are limited, means these are in a very less extent available, which we are going to finish very soon. Okay, so coal and petroleum can come in it. Okay, exhaustible resources, inexhaustible resources, coal and petroleum can be included, because coal and petroleum is going to finish. Coal is going to finish in next 200 years, and petroleum is going to, means all petrol and kerosene, all products are going to be finished within next 50 years. So these resources are going to be finished. Such resources are called as a exhaustible resources. Okay, then what would happen after getting finished these all resources? Then our turn would come to form the coal and petroleum. You are knowing, students, the formation of coal and petroleum. Okay, so it will be our turn to form coal and petroleum to get these same kind of resources for our future generation. Okay, so this will come into the exhaustible resources. Exhaustible resources means limited resources, or these are not replenishable, or these are not rechargeable. We cannot get them back. Okay, such resources which are present in the limited amount on the earth, this is called as a exhaustible resources. And exactly opposite of it, inexhaustible resources. What is mean by inexhaustible resources? These are unlimited, abundant. These are in the abundant form into the environment. Such resources are called as a inexhaustible resources. Can you name me such? Yes, you only I am asking. Yes, air, water, sunlight, these are coming into the inexhaustible resources. I mean, these are not going to be finished. Okay, so there are mainly two kinds of resources, natural resources, that are exhaustible resources and inexhaustible resources.